GatorSports.com.
Hi, and welcome to a special Swampcast. I'm Jeff Barlis, the editor of GatorSports.com, and I'm here with Robbie Andreu, the staff writer and football beat writer for GatorSports.com and the Gainesville Sun. We're here to preview a very special day of football without a football game.
Huge day, Jeff. Huge.
Wednesday is pro day and the start of spring practice at Florida, and it's just going to be a mammoth day without any actual football, but there's expected to be thousands of not thousands.
Possibly. You don't know. With Tebow, he's the X factor. 4,000 or 5,000 to show up. You never know. I mean, Florida is actually encouraging fans and selling things at the concession stand. Well, they've never done anything like that for pro day. They've kind of discouraged fans. Now they're saying, come on in and watch.
UF Pro Day. Yeah, the Tebow Circus will be on display at UF Pro Day. It starts around 10 or 10:30 in the morning. There's going to be all the NFL scouts on hand, probably a lot of NFL dignitaries, head coaches from all over. I think we'll have to keep an eye on Jacksonville to see if Jack Del Rio, the owner, the concession stands people are there.
Well, Del Rio has said at the Senior Bowl he was too early to form an opinion on Tebow. I think now maybe he has an opinion. We'll try to get that out of him. But there's some pressure for Jacksonville to really look at Tebow there, maybe in the first round.
So Tebow is obviously the big story at Pro Day, but we're expecting as many as a dozen or 15 other players.
Yeah, Florida's projecting 15 or maybe even above that, and that's one of the reasons that a lot of the scouts are going to be here, Jeff. Not just Tebow, but Hayden and Dunlap, all those guys. So it's going to be a huge day for the NFL guys to be in games a lot. I know a few years ago there were only maybe a couple of dozen. We're going to see close to 100 probably.
And with all the scouts, the attention is going to be squarely on Tim Tebow. ESPN will be there. The NFL Network is going to be broadcasting. Tebow is supposedly going to unveil his new throwing mechanics. What do we expect to see?
Well, he's tightened it up. He's been working with Mark Trestman and Zeke Prakowski, so he's tightened it up. Now, can he do that when the action's kind of live? You can do it standing around throwing. It'll be interesting to see how he does under pressure. And there will be pressure on him with his new throwing motion here. So I'm looking forward to seeing it and seeing how he throws the ball and who he throws it to.
Speaking of the rest of the former Gators who are going to be on display, there could be as many as 7 players picked on the first day, first 2 rounds of the NFL draft.
Yeah, and Joe Hayden, he's basically going to be a first-round pick, even though he had that bad time at the combine. I think he'll improve on that time, and he'll get right back to where he was. And a lot of people are saying Cleveland fairly early, so I think that time has kind of thrown him off a little bit. But he has a chance in the pro day here to get his time back down and put him back high in the first round.
Save himself some millions that people are speculating he may have lost.
Yeah.
So the other first rounders that are projected for Florida are Carlos Dunlap and perhaps Marquise Pouncey sneaking into the bottom of the first round.
Yeah, I think Pouncey might get in maybe before Dunlap. I think there are concerns about character issues with Dunlap and his work ethic. But, I think Pouncey's a guy with a great work ethic and a real strong guy and a real intelligent guy, and that's what you need to play center in the NFL. I think his stock is up and Dunlap's is going down a little bit.
Now, of the possible second-rounders, who would you put at the top of that list? Brandon Spikes, Aaron Hernandez, possibly even Riley Cooper getting into the second round?
I think all the above there, maybe Tim Tebow as well. But I think Hernandez is a guy, if you're looking for an H-back guy, receiving tight end, somebody's going to jump on him pretty early in the second round, I would think. And, Dunlap could be a steal in the second round, which is where he may end up, and somebody's going to benefit from that if they can get him to bust his butt consistently.
Are there questions about Brandon Spike's speed his position? Because obviously he's got a great resume from college.
I think people are concerned about how he's going to run. He didn't run at the combine. I think they're wondering how he's going to run here. And I think whatever he runs the 40, and once you get this guy in camp and you see how good he is physically and how well he plays that position, they'll be fine. But there are concerns about his 40 time right now.
Well, when all of the pro day festivities are over,
and it could last a while with so many people, so.
Yeah, and who knows how many fans will show up, but we'll just cross the street a little while later that afternoon to go to the first day of UF spring football practice. And again, the big story of the day there, it's kind of a day of big stories, is Urban Meyer's return from his leave of absence.
Yeah, and he's told us, he told me a few weeks ago, he's definitely coming back and feels better. He told Mike Bianchi that the other day. So, I expect him to be there, and, I wonder what his role is going to be. Being the spring, I think he'll just be the head coach again. Some have said, well, maybe he'll be there just to observe, but I think he's going to be the head coach and take his team back over.
What else can we look forward to with spring football practice beginning, culminating in the April 10th Orange and Blue game? This is kind of a passing of the baton from Tebow over at Florida Field to John Brantley. Yeah.
And Jeff, you know, we talked about Pro Day. There's going to be 15 guys over there. That just shows you how much rebuilding Florida has to do on the other side of the street on the practice field. So, you know, John Brantley takes over quarterback. I think people are excited about what he can bring to the offense. And I think the offense is going to be very similar to what we saw in the Sugar Bowl. A lot of downfield passing, wide receiver involved, line up in the eye a little bit and run the ball. Tailbacks are going to like that.
And speaking of that, do we expect to see a lot of a lot more involvement of the running backs? There certainly are a lot of them now.
I think so. And I think, you know, you're going to have the fullback more involved. You're going to line up in the eye, get the receivers more involved. And, you know, I think Brantley brings another dimension to the offense. He's not going to run the ball a whole lot. They'll have the option in there a little bit still. But, you know, he's not going to take off and run on third and two like Tebow did. They're going to be more of a conventional offense. Meyer's really good about, you know, building an offense around the talent, and I think we're going to see that this spring.
What else do we expect to look for out there? There's new coaches, new players all over.
Yeah, four new coaches. So, you know, new defensive coordinator. You know, Austin says that he's going to basically keep running what Charlie was doing, maybe add a little thing here or there. And he's another guy that says, you know, I'm not really sure what we're going to do until we know what we have to work with. And, you know, they're going to have a lot of talented guys, and if he can cover man-to-man with his cornerbacks, he's going to do a lot of the same things Charlie Strong did, blitzing and all that. And we're going to see more 3-4, I think, out of this guy.
Well, we'll see you out there at the UF practice field. We'll be there the whole spring. And
that one day is going to seem like the whole spring, I
guess. Yeah, it's going to be a long day, but we'll have all kinds of live coverage on our website, photo galleries and message board, live reports and videos. So stay tuned to Gatorsports.com, and we'll see you out there. For Robbie Andreu, I'm Jeff Barlis.